Hello everybody and welcome to NEET Mentor. In this particular session, we are going to talk in detail about MDMS seat matrix state-wise for recognized and permitted seats for all the states. So how many seats are recognized and how many seats are permitted for MD as well as MS. Before we jump into the list of recognized and permitted seats for particular state, let's take a look at total number of MDMS seats availability. So it's 38,180. Recognized seats are 32,607 and permitted is 4,661. If in case you are watching this video at later point of time and the number of seats is further increased, then don't blame me because it's up to date seat matrix. And PG diploma 2 years back in 2020 and before that also, the number of PG diploma seats got converted into degree seats. That's why we have less number of PG diploma seats. 864 seats are those which are recognized and 48 seats are permitted. Those seats which are permitted now, they will get converted into recognized seats after 3 years, one batch of the permitted seats is passed out. Okay, so minimum 3 years of time that it takes to get converted, to convert permitted seat into recognized seat. So the total MD seat is 24,514, and I will give you the detail in tabular format for permitted as well as recognized seat. So these are the permitted and recognized seat. For Andhra Pradesh, there are totally 1411 seats in MD and 221 are permitted, remaining 1190 are recognized. I am not going to read out each and everything. You can take a screenshot and for your own state, you can take it into consideration for further analysis how many seats are available. In Delhi, we have 1293 seats and 1237 are recognized and 56 are permitted. In Chandigarh, there are 301 seats and these MDMS seats are those including government and private. It's not just for government, including private colleges, government colleges and deemed university, PG diploma as well. So all the MDMS seats, DNB seats are not included here. I will create a separate video for DNB seat matrix. This year we have got DNB seat also increased by around 1,500 is the total number, 1,500 to 1,700 is the total number for DNB and FNB. And there is increment of 4,148 in the seats of MDMS inclusion. Let's take a look at number of seats availability in Karnataka. It has got highest number of seats in MD, that is 3,335. 557 seats are permitted. So you can assume that in last 3 years, these many seats got added. Maharashtra has got 2,974 seats. Out of that, 2,669 are recognized and 325 are permitted. Tamil Nadu has got 2,160 seats and Telangana 1,369 seats. Uttar Pradesh 1,671 seats. Recently, more colleges got PG courses, particularly in private colleges. So PG courses started in Uttar Pradesh and it's also good option if you have low score. Rajasthan has your 1,269 seats. Now take a look at total MS seats available in India across private colleges, government colleges, diploma courses and deemed universities. 12,774. So there is a list of all the MS seats, both permitted and recognized state-wise. Take a look at Andhra Pradesh. So hardly you can see in MS, we have more than 1,000 seats. Only in Karnataka and Maharashtra has got more than 1,000 seats and more Tamil Nadu state. So these three states has got highest number of seats in MS. So when you say MS, all these branches, general surgery, orthopedics, ophthalmology and ENT, these branches will be coming under Ops and Gynae. Tamil Nadu has got 1,319 seats and 1069 are recognized and 250 are permitted. You can take a screenshot because it's like very time consuming to read out all the digits here. It's just for your reference. I'm giving you in tabular format. Madhya Pradesh has got 520 seats, including private and government and diploma seats. 58 are permitted and 462 are recognized. And there are a bunch of candidates who are very interested to take diploma seats. They assume that the score is low, or like 5000, 10000 beyond the cutoff mark of MSMD degree seats in government colleges, they can easily get diploma seats. It's not like that. Since the number of diploma seats is less, the cutoff for diploma seats will also go in parallel. You won't find much of difference. You can find difference of like maximum 5000 between the cutoff of any degree course and diploma course in the same, because the number of seats are less. And in the state of Delhi, 650 is the total MS seat, 19 seats are permitted and 631 are recognized. Andhra Pradesh has got 797 seats and 84 are permitted, 713 are recognized. So this is just to give you an idea so that you can start your homework, your analysis. You can foresee what is going to happen when the counseling process starts. So 85% of the calculation you can do based on the prediction, based on your expected score. Based on the expected score, you can get predicted rank, and based on that rank, you can get an idea in which state you have the possibility to get particular branch. List out your dream branches and then go for it. Don't get demotivated. See, you don't judge the score just by looking at the score. The score might be good for particular branch. If it's not good for top clinical like medicine, pediatrics, but it might be good score for lower clinical. So it depends on your interest. There are candidates who are equally interested into dermatology and ophthalmology or ENT. So they are okay to go with the second option. For dermatology, the score might be very poor, but for ENT or ophthalmology, which is lower clinical branches, your score might be good, and you can get government colleges as well. So it doesn't, don't just overlook your score. You have to analyze what is possible, whether DNB is possible in your category, what is possible in government, what is possible in DNB. So all the analysis you need to do, and if you are not able to get DNB or government colleges, what is the possibility that you have in lower budget private medical colleges? Okay, so all these things you need to analyze. For that you need good set of data for all the states, seat matrix, cutoff, tuition fee structure, stipend amount, bond years. These all things you need to have. In case you think you are not able to analyze and come to a conclusion, you are in under stress or have no clarity, you can come to NEET Mentor. You can contact our 9319128677. You can avail our paid guidance services as well. With paying a minimal amount, you can get a lot of benefits, because this PG course will decide your future. MBBS, there was no branch, but there you have to choose your department, and based on your interest, you need to choose the department. If you are like very passionate about particular branch and you are trying to manage it, I won't suggest doing that, because I know people who had done their PG, MD in pathology, and they are trying to do second MD in their dream branch. So you should not go that route. Based on your future perspective, whether you want to go for lecturer post or teaching faculty, government job, your own establishing your own setup. So all those factors you need to keep in mind when you're choosing your branch and your seats and probability of getting the seats in particular budget or government or DNB. So with this, I'm finishing my video, and we will meet again with some important details so you can get benefited out of this channel. So thanks for watching again, and have a great day. Goodbye.